Hi, welcome to our film on currency in an independent Scotland.
You might well be asking, would an independent Scotland need its own currency?
A good question. You may also wonder why. Why change it? Why try something that's never been done before? In fact, why even bother with independence?
For a long time, Scotland has been used as a dumping ground and a testing lab by Westminster and its government.
From nuclear weapons to poll tax, bedroom tax, universal credit, airport tax and numerous indirect taxes to take every penny it can from the man in the street. The kid to super rich and big businesses would pay almost no tax. There is some hope though that could get us away from all of this. And that hope lies not just with political independence, but financial independence. And that is why a re-independent Scotland has to have its own currency.
Let's give you a little background information on that.
In 1776, an economist and a philosopher called Adam Smith wrote a book called The Wealth of Nations.
This book was laid out in such a clear and scientific way, it made it very easy to understand. And it earned him the title of the father of modern day economics. Another famous economist was John Maynard Keynes, who in 1936 published a book that completely changed the UK economy.
When Clement Attlee became the Prime Minister of a bankrupt UK, he brought in Keynes as his main economical advisor. And Keynes was the man to deal with it.
Keynes had the government nationalise the Bank of England in order to create money and avoid paying interest to private banks.
One of the biggest tasks was to set up something that had never been done before, a national health service, free at the point of delivery. Next came public ownership of the utilities, water, mining, electricity, gas and railways, etc.
After 6 years, the Attlee government left office with less debt, created full employment and with considerable public assets.
That brings us back to our earlier questions. Why try something that's never been done before? Well, it has been done before, and very effectively at that. Attlee and Keynes were the proof of that. The current system is broke, and an independent Scotland needs to change it to create wealth for our nation and our people.
You might also ask, what if no one will trade with us if it's not sterling anymore?
That's right. Scotland exports more than it imports.
Let's not forget as well that we have a thriving games industry and we build more satellites than anywhere else in Europe.
So who in their right mind wouldn't want to come to Scotland or trade with us?
So what if I want to buy something from America or from Ireland? Can I still do that?
Of course you can. You would simply pay for your goods from abroad the same way you do just now.
So the National Bank or credit card company simply exchanges that money into the currency of the receiving bank, which is just the same as we do now.
The bigger question is, how do we balance the books and avoid paying millions in interest?
The answer to that is also quite simple. We set up a Scottish bank, a Scottish mint, and a full reserve currency.
Currently we use a system called fractional reserve where banks can create digital money on their computers. They send money to the Bank of England as hard cash as a deposit and then create additional money out of thin air.
So a bank can send £1 million to the Bank of England and then create an additional £9 million of digital money with nothing to back it up. This is what caused the banks to fail and required us to bail them out. Yet, they continue to work in this fashion, heading towards the next crash.
A full reserve currency works like this. Banks can only lend what they already have in reserve.
Some people will also want to put money into the banks for a rainy day, and they'll do that through savings plans, which in turn will give the banks more money to lend out. So that means that banks are unlikely to go bust because they're working with the money that they have. That's just like me and you do every day.
The same way we did when we converted from old shillings and pennies to decimal money back in the 1970s.
The Scottish Government gets the new Scottish Central Bank to create money for it. The Central Bank replaces all sterling notes held by banks within Scotland with the new currency on a one-to-one basis.
To create jobs for us all and to boost the economy, the Government then invests this money into high unemployment areas to build infrastructure, such as hospitals, schools, roads, houses, etc.
So these new jobs bring in taxes from the wages, and also the materials for most of these jobs will be sourced locally.
This means not only do we get money back from taxation, but supply and demand for materials then increases as well, which returns more tax.
This in turn creates additional jobs and additional taxes from the companies that are supplying these goods and services.
On top of that, people who have these new jobs will then spend that money on new products and services, or even larger items such as cars or houses.
So we end up with all these new jobs, and supply and demand increased. Lots of new public assets and not a penny paid in interest to a private bank.
We hope that's given you something to think about. Thank you for watching our video.